Our next contest, ladies and gentlemen, will be fought for the Road to Victory, a light heavyweight amateur mixed martial arts title belt. Our first challenger making his way to the blue corner. Please welcome Kiarash Majidi. And our second challenger, making his way to the red corner, please welcome James Padula. Introducing these two title challengers once again, fighting out of the blue corner, representing Novo BJJ, he is Kiarash Majidi. And fighting out of the red corner, representing one BJJ, he is James Padula.
This is our second title fight of the night, amateur MMA in the light heavyweight division. Kiarash in the world's greatest shorts, the white and red hearts. James Padula in the valet 2 day shorts, black ones.
Both wrestling. Good work.
Big takedown.
Forward wasn't working, so he went backwards.
The thing that's interesting is for Kiarash, he made his debut in this same place. He was stopped in that fight in the first round. So to come full circle and
wow,
look
huge
at that.
Huge takedown.
A few fights later, he's fighting for the title, getting huge takedowns like that. It just shows you what you can do when you stick at it.
Picking no shots. Kiarash top position. Looks to take the back.
Oh, look at that!
From Kiarash. Big shots fired in.
Kiarash taking him on a flight.
A little bit unusual there, Ami, that he hasn't moved himself into position for a rear naked choke. He's just kind of settled on controlling the top position.
Yeah, do you know what it is? I think he kind of looks at it and thinks he's got more options staying on top than he does if he just goes for the rear naked.
Beautiful break. Opens up the left and a right.
The style that Kiarash has got is a very punishing style. He wants to take you down. He wants to put you in position and just beat you up. And that is a very large, strong man.
Kiarash just above his opponent's corner, top position. Very much in control of James Padula. Big left hand.
Padula's in a little bit of trouble here. Be interesting to see if he can work his way out of this position, if he can try and regain guard.
Yeah, Kiarash very much in control. Big shot underneath from Kiarash again. He steps through to the back. Doesn't take it, doesn't set both hooks.
Big shot.
Lands the hammer fist. And again, you can look for the takedown. If he can get his hands just around the waist of...
The problem for James is that Kiarash is not expending a huge amount of energy. He doesn't look like he's gassing. He doesn't look like he's blowing. Kiarash can do this for 3 rounds, 5 rounds if necessary.
And there we are.
Kiarash top position. Looks to take the back.
Big slam
again from Kiarash. Big shots fired in. Rhythm. Find his way into it.
But James has got an experienced corner himself. You see, UFC veteran, Octagon veteran, John Hathaway in his corner. Kiarash, you see, Bellator veteran, Stephen Hillbilly Hill in his corner. So both fighters have got an experienced corner. I'm sure they've been in these positions in training. So we'll just see who can implement the best in the second round. But I'll be interested to see what kind of adjustments James is able to make, if any.
So here we go.
Guys, please excuse the profanity. That is actually Kiarash's mother with shouts of affection and support. We love it.
Kiarash again closes that distance.
I was going to say that would have been that's a really big moment for James, stuffing the takedown and not getting taken down immediately. If he can defend up against the fence now, that is a huge, huge win for him in this round.
Kiarash looked for the single, almost gave up his neck, but his head free. Looking to switch. Listening to his corner's instruction very well. James just trying to control Kiarash. Trying to get on the out. Beautiful.
Oh, lovely takedown.
Beautiful drag.
It's difficult when you're fighting someone that's just that powerful and they're just, when they decide they can dump you on your head, it's difficult to defend against that. It's got that Derek Lewis power.
So James at the moment with a closed guard. Kiarash coming up right. Needs to be careful. The ankle pick is there for James as he went with the up kicks.
Oh, great job there from James getting back to his feet.
Good work. Looking for a takedown of his own now. Kiarash sprawls wide. Good knee to the thigh.
The difficulty here is James actually hasn't had an opportunity to get any offense going, so we haven't had an opportunity to really see his offensive wrestling or even see his striking. We've not even really had a chance to see either.
Good reversal by Kiarash there. Put his opponent back against the cage. Kiarash again looking for that takedown. Beautiful. Oh,
lovely single.
Turns a corner, gets a takedown. Needs to be careful now, the triangle leg. The legs for the triangle just creeping up. Seem to be climbing deep. Kiarash needs to be, make sure that he's keeping his opponent compressed. Doesn't lose an arm. Closed guard. Last few seconds of this round. Upright. Needs to be careful. The ankle pick is there for James as he went with the up kicks.
Oh, great job there from James.
Upright.
He just seems like he's just one step behind. But he still looks confident and I feel like he'll still continue trying to win in there. But now it's just about how much energy has Kiarash spent. Does he have it in him to continue doing what he's already done so far?
See, for me, as it moves into the latter rounds, it's when it opens it up that little bit more. You know, when you get guys this heavy, as we discussed, it takes that one shot.
Yeah, 100%. And the thing is that with such a wrestling heavy style like that, all it takes is for James Padula to stuff one takedown and then circle out and then start throwing hands in the middle of the thing, because we haven't seen any offense from James so far, so we don't know. If James can stuff the takedown, he might be lethal with his hands. We don't know yet.
And just as you said that, he leads with a jab. Tried to get the neck, didn't quite get it.
Oh, he's shooting in for his own takedown.
Well, arguably, it's where the points have been scored in the takedowns, in the control on the ground.
He
gets it. So maybe James feels this is where he can actually get back into it as he takes to the mount position.
I was about to say, look at the size of his legs. How silly would you be to think you can get that takedown? And he got it. So now let's see how Kiarash does off of his back now. He's got great grappling experience, a great grappling team behind him. But someone of that size, I'm sure he's not often on his back, especially not mounted like this. So it'll be interesting to see how does he defend this and does he get out of this. How much energy has he got to get out of this?
I think Kiarash should be comfortable here. He won't be, this isn't a position he won't have been in thousands of times. But like you say, it's how he deals with it under pressure.
Yeah, for sure, for sure.
So James again, just trying to control that wrist, looking to control the arm, get some clean shots, fired away. Good work by James, sits up, looks to fire. Again, just popping shots.
Yeah, listen, and you see Kiarash, yeah, he's bucking like crazy. Because remember, as though it's a title fight, it's an amateur MMA title fight. They're not going to let him take a lot of shots in that position. They're not going to let him take much.
Yeah, Kiarash just holding on, possibly looking for the reset. But beautiful work. Gets the sweep onto his knees.
That is huge right there. Huge moment there.
James on his back, looked to work with his legs.
The title may have been secured, I can't lie.
Beautiful, climbs into the triangle.
It's looking like he's looking in the triangle.
Kiarash still has another arm through.
Oh, man!
Does well to escape. Woo!
Listen, shouts to James Padula, because James Padula has made this a fight. He could have laid there and just got beat up for three rounds, but he didn't give up. In this third round, he's still trying to win every second he can. So shouts to these boys, man. They made this a real fight. I love it.
James starting to climb back to his feet.
But think about how much energy James just spent doing all of that. Taking down Kiarash, trying to hold him down, getting in mount.
Kiarash will potentially look for a takedown from this position. Depending on the gas in the tank. And there he is. Has another arm through.
Oh, man!
Does well to escape. Woo!
Listen, shouts to James Padula, because James Padula has made this a fight. He could have laid there and just got... I feel like Kiarash really exercised some demons in here. Great performance. And I believe that he's going to cap off this performance with a belt around his waist.
So it'll be over to the judges to find out who gets to take the strap, the coveted road to victory.
Home with them.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three fantastic rounds of championship mixed martial arts, we go to the judges' scorecards and we have a split decision in favor of your winner and new Road to Victory light heavyweight amateur mixed martial arts champion, Kiarash Majidi!